Hello, my name is Danny Nolan and I'm the Director of Chassis Sim Technologies. Welcome to this latest episode of Dan's Vehicle Dynamics Corner. Today, we've got a real treat for you. What we're going to be talking about is creating tyre models from scratch. In particular, I'm going to be talking to you about some techniques that we've been using in the Chassis Sim community now for a couple of months that have produced some really stunning results. And where a lot of this has come from is when you have to start from a blank sheet of paper. To kick things off, one of the biggest sticking points that I always see in simulation is tyres. And in particular, probably the biggest objection that I will see when people get started with simulation or not getting started with simulation is, oh, we have no idea what the tyres are, or we think the tyre test rig results are in fantasy land, therefore we cannot start. Well, I can tell you right now, with what I'm about to show you today, I'm about to blow that misconception well and truly into the weeds. The great thing is there's a really simple approximation of a tyre model that's going to get you going. And in particular, it's the second order traction circle radius versus load characteristic approximation of that. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, the second order traction circle radius versus load equation. Now, if you have been watching the Dan's Vehicle Dynamics Corner episodes, or indeed any Chassis Sim tutorials, or read any of my Race Car Engineering articles, one of the things I will always stress is that if you can get the traction circle radius versus load characteristic of your tyre right, it will forgive a multitude of sins. Now, the building block of this is the second order traction circle radius versus load equation. That is, traction circle radius is Ka, the initial coefficient of friction, times 1 minus Kb times Fz, all multiplied by Fz. Okay, the Ka is the initial coefficient of friction. Kb is how that initial coefficient of friction drops off linearly with load. So as you can see, this is a pretty simple but benign equation, but you can do some really clever stuff with this that is very, very powerful. And if anything, what you're seeing here is pretty much the base building block of any tyre model. Okay, so let's get some numbers to this. Okay, firstly, for some typical open wheeler numbers, we've got a Ka of 2 and a Kb of 5 times e to the minus 5. However, where things get really, really interesting is the fact that we can express the peak load as 1 on 2 times Kb. What the peak load represents is where the maximum possible tyre force of that model lies. That, ladies and gentlemen, is something that's really, really significant, because using this, to quote the Joker from The Dark Knight in the Batman trilogy, I'm about to show you guys a magic trick. Here's the magic trick. The great thing about the second order traction circle radius versus load characteristic is it allows us to express any tyre model in terms of its peak load and the force that we desire. And typically what we've got here is we've got our peak load and we've got our peak force being Ka times Lp on 2. If we know those two things, we can go a very, very long way to approximate what we need from our tyre model, because it is just those two key things we need to know. What's the peak tyre load and what's the peak force that we require? Once we have that, we are well on our way. So, the first thing we need to do is we need to determine where the peak loads. Now, you can do this in a number of ways. You can do it through data, you can do it through hand calculations, or you can do it through simulation. Now, the great thing about Chassis Sim is that you could probably do this either using our lap time simulation, or you can do it using our track replay simulation. Either way, it's totally up to you. But the moral of the tale here is we need to get some idea of where the max tyre load is going to be, because that's going to determine our peak tyre load, or our LP. So what we've got here is that we've got a plot of front tire loads and rear tire loads. So here we've got a peak tire load of about 400 kilos at the front and about 523 kilos at the rear. Now, as a rough rule of thumb, what I'll do is I'll add about a 100 kilo delta. The reason I do that is that we don't want the peak load happening at where we see the peak tire load for our particular data. The reason we don't want to do that is we don't want the tire to saturate. We need to give it some wiggle room. Once we know that, we then need to determine the forces that we need. Now, the great thing about this is that is just simply a simple static force balance. So what we've got here is that the total front lateral force is the front weight distribution times MT times the peak curvature for that particular corner times the velocity at which that corner speed actually happens. And the rear is exactly the same thing, except this time it's 1 minus the weight distribution. Now, the key thing is what we're doing is we're taking this equation here and we're equating it to this little puppy here where FZ is the inside and outside load of the tire. That is really, really key because effectively it gives us a force balance. Now, in terms of how you go about implementing this, a really good way of doing this is combining this all into an Excel sheet. So what we've got here is an Excel sheet that I use, and honestly, it doesn't get any prize for being sexy or pretty, but it's functional. So what I've got here is that I've got my front roll center, my rear roll center, my front weight distribution, my front and rear tire spring rates, my front spring rate, my roll bar rate, my rear spring rate, my CG height, my front track, rear track, my motion ratios. I also put in here what my CLA is and what my aero balance is. And what I also do here is I'll enter a corner speed that I'm interested in. So I'll open up some data. I'll take a look at say what the car is doing at 100 kilometers an hour, for instance. And then what that does is that returns what my tire loads are for this particular corner. Here's where things get interesting. In this Excel sheet, I've got my front KA and I've got my rear KA, my initial coefficient of friction. And what I will do is I will play with that to get what I want from my desired tire curve. And I've rigged this up as a simple force balance that it will return what the maximum possible cornering speed is for all these conditions. And I will play with KA at the front and KA at the rear to make sure that those speeds in my Excel sheet match up what I see in my data. And what that does is it gives me a rough stab in the dark about what that tire curve is. Then what I can do is then I can plug this into the chassis sim tire force modeling quick start, and then I can go through, I can play with grip factors, I can do some rough tuning first, and then I can go into the tire force modeling toolbox to fill in the blanks. That is really, really, really key, ladies and gentlemen. I cannot ram this point home hard enough. So, in summary, the great thing is a tire model using a second order using a using the second order fit of the traction circle radius versus load characteristic can be expressed as the peak load and force that you desire. You use data and simulation or hand calcs to determine the tire load. What you do is totally up to you. You then use a simple force balance to determine the initial coefficient of friction that you need. And once you've got this, you plug this into chassis sim, run some basic sims, and use the tire force modeling toolbox to fill in the rest. That, ladies and gentlemen, is your game plan about how you create tire models from scratch, and this is now being applied in the chassis sim community for the last couple of months, and the results have been quite stunning. However, do not take my word for it. If you're in the chassis sim community already, give this a run. Go through this tube, and then go through this episode and break it down step by step. If you're not in the chassis sim community, go to the Chassis Sim website, register for our online simulation, buy a few credits, and see for yourself what a powerful technique this is. And I will catch you in the next episode of Dan's Vehicle Dynamics Corner.